My name is Ryan Schmid, and I am a student missionary here in Mondulkiri, Cambodia this year. And I've been working among the Bunong. The Bunong are an animistic minority in Cambodia. They, their whole life and religion and culture centers around their animistic beliefs. And what it means to be animist is basically they see the world as a populated place, populated full of spirits and angels and demons and gods. And so they center their lives around trying to appease, through sacrificial rituals, these spirits. They ask them to come and bless their fields or to protect their houses. They tie strings on the wrists of their children and on the necks, all with the intention of helping keep the spirits away or allowing the spirits to bless them. And so the point of the work here is to take these Bunong who have these amazing lives where they live amongst their fields, they work day by day. They have this thing they call the way, which is where they all go one field owned by one person, all of them will go to that field and work one day. And a different day, everyone will go to a different person's field. And there's no exchange of money, just exchange of labor and fellowship in many ways. So we're trying to take this beautiful Bunong ethnicity and religion and transform it into something Christ-centered and God-fearing. And my work here has mainly been to take the believers and to disciple them and to do some might call church planting. I have been working with a man named Makara, who's been translating for me, and also he's been teaching and doing all sorts of English classes and literacy stuff. But we basically day by day go to houses of like the Giap family or Bayo and Quinn's house or Mao's house, and we'll go and just do Bible studies with them. We studied a lot through Genesis 1 through 11, some really important stuff, the foundational text of the entire scriptures, and the stuff that really applies to people like them because they're Gentiles. They don't have a Jewish background at all or even a Western background. And so these stories really hit them and touch them in ways that are really incredible. And so we've had a lot of experience just going and teaching and singing. Every time we go, we'd sing with them for 15 or 20 minutes, pray with them 15 or 20 minutes, study 15 or 20 minutes, sometimes even longer, and just fellowship together with these different guys, these different believers. And then we've also been doing Bible studies. When we first got here, there were no baptized believers. Soon after that, though, Greg and Molly had been studying with the Giap family, but Giap and Megiap, and they were able to be baptized, so we have two currently. But Makara and myself have been working and studying with Bayo and Quinn, Mao and Mabia, with the intention that before we leave, all four of them, or at least Bayo and Quinn, will be baptized. So we'll have doubled or tripled the number of immersed people in this congregation, which is really incredible. And it's not just like we're baptizing them for numbers. They've really grown in incredible ways. Bayo has devoted large portions of the scriptures to her memory. Quinn and Giap and Mao have all acted in just really helpful servant-driven ways, just trying to make Makara and myself have lives that are easier. But Giap has volunteered a lot of time to help us with our house and fix things that we need fixing. They're just really incredible people, and so we've been doing that. And then I've also gotten the privilege while I've been here to work on some materials for the scriptures. These people, they are just beginning to learn how to read, and they've been learning a lot through the scriptures. And so part of what we've been doing is teaching them and introducing them to the scriptures, but there are a lot of books in the Bible, and we haven't gotten to cover all of them. And so Greg has given me the opportunity to write introductions and brief summaries of every single book in the Bible that will be made into like a small book translated into Khmer that these believers will be able to use so that when they open up their Bible to Micah, they won't just get confused and shut it again because it's a bunch of crazy Hebrew meditation literature and poetry and has all this language and metaphor. But instead, they'll be able to look at the introduction and see what the book is about, who the author was, and then go and use the summary to guide them through the immersion to the scriptures. And then I've also been able to help Greg and Molly and the team here start some rituals, some traditions that will help replace the traditions and rituals that they've had as Bunong, because as I mentioned before, they're animist. So when they go to bless their fields, they sacrifice animals and set up bamboo fetishes with the intention of inviting the rice god to come down and bless their fields. And so Greg gave me the opportunity, a humbling opportunity, to try and take these rituals that they have and make them into Christ-centered, God-fearing rituals and traditions that will allow them to maintain their Bunong ethnicity, because we know that when Messiah returns, he's going to want people from every nation, language, and tongue. but that they'll also be Christian. They'll also be followers and disciples of Jesus. And to find that balance between maintaining Bunang identity and maintaining Christian identity has been a great challenge and a great journey, and something that will be really helpful for just my future in general. And hopefully it'll be something that will be useful and long-lasting here, if God wills, among the community. So it's really been an amazing experience to be able to not only work and disciple these believers, but to also create things that will stay behind and last long after I'm gone.